All right, fire away.
How was the whole experience today, Rick?
It's been great. Everything kind of started. Oh, battery needs to get in.
Hang on,
I'm on the charge. Fine, like camera crew, I guess. No, experience has been great. We got in Wednesday afternoon. Actually scheduled a shoot for one of my sponsors for Thursday morning. Worked out perfectly, and we've had a great time from yesterday. We had a Cowboy Brian was our fundraiser for the golf team. On that, we did a live spot here during the walk around. This last night, and parade this morning, so it's just been definitely a full schedule, but we've enjoyed every moment.
What is it about your experience here in Oklahoma State that you continue to be such a great ambassador for the school?
I think homecoming weekend is, you know, when people see it, I think they understand a little bit more about what Oklahoma State is, what it stands for, the family, the amount of people that come back and turn out for the walk around to the parade this morning. You always feel like you either know people in the crowd or people that are out there, and if you don't, it doesn't feel like you're very far removed from them. You know, so there's going to be a mutual friend or someone in common. I mean, it's a big family, and I got to be a part of that for 2 years, and that was long enough to make it ongoing and enough of a lifetime.
Was there something about those 2 years that you spent here that made this place really important to you?
Well, I mean, the main reason I came here was to play golf and use it as a stepping stone to get to my next point in my career, which is to ultimately be on the PGA Tour. I was able to do that, and this was, you know, a great place for me to do that. I was able to get everything done that I wanted to, continue my golf career, but at the same time, have a place that is forever going to be a part of me, even though it was only the 2 years. It's a place I love to come back to, enjoy coming back to. I feel like I've been able to make some stops here and go practice and play with the team and still use it as a, not just a place to come back and have fun, but I can come back and get stuff done if I need to. So it was exactly what I needed for, like I talked about, kind of that stepping stone to get to the next point in my career.
How often do you try to make it back here? I know you come to a couple football games every year, right?
Yeah, so last year was the first year that I wasn't able to make it back since I left school. Yeah, at least try and get back for the Cowboy Pro-Am and the football game. And typically the Pro-Am is around a football game, and so I can get both knocked out on the weekend. There's been a couple of years where I've made it back twice. For the most part, it's just once, which is enough, but I wish there was more. If I can make it back at least once every year, it's special. Kind of fills that little hole in there. But yeah, I'd like to try and make it back more, but busy schedule it makes it tough.
When did OSU first start contacting you about being OSU Grand Marshal?
I'm not sure exactly when it first came up. I know my agent played golf here at Oklahoma State early 90s, and so he's still close with everyone here at Oklahoma State. And so I think the talk with him and some of the guys here started a little while back, and it had come to me a little earlier this year. And once I figured out my fall schedule, I wasn't going to be playing a whole lot with the Pro-Am being the day before homecoming game. This whole weekend kind of worked out perfectly with me kind of not playing as much this fall. Getting to come and be homecoming, be Grand Marshal, be here to play in the Pro-Am and make it a fun trip. We're actually going from here. We're going to get to my girlfriend's homecoming next week in Cal. Kind of doing a road trip, flying around the country in a way.
Ricky, I don't know if you had a moment to kind of look back on your year on the tour, but did you feel like you grew in a certain way?
It was definitely my most consistent and probably best year stats-wise. I didn't have as many wins as I would have liked to, but It was a really good year. Like I said, best stats wise, which is nice to look across the board and know that one of the best in a lot of categories. We had a lot of success and nice to go win the President's Cup like we did a couple of weeks ago. So I think the last time I had a really good year, I won three times, and then the year after wasn't as good. So this is a chance for me to go and kind of better things and ultimately go next year and get ourselves a major.
You had multiple opportunities like the President's Cup to play representing the country. What's that like?
Anytime you get to throw red, white, and blue on, playing for your country is pretty special. It's almost like getting to come back here and put orange on and be in front of, almost like my hometown crowd. But when you throw the red, white, and blue on, whether it's, being down in Rio, playing the Olympics, even though that's not as much of a team atmosphere, definitely a different feeling. But being able to be down there, one of the coolest experiences for me is being in the opening ceremonies down there. But the other times, from Ryder Cup to President's Cup to World Cup last year, the team events are fun. It kind of gets you back thinking of, how it was in almost high school golf to college golf here, being on a team with guys. It's rare for our sport just because it only happens once, maybe a couple times a year tops, but you have to earn your way there. So it doesn't just happen, you have to make it on this team.
How is it coming back to Carson? Any fun troubles?
I'm definitely in off-season form right now, so Carson presents plenty of troubles for my golf game at the state right now. But it's just fun going back and playing and remembering, of course, that I spent a bunch of time on for 2 years I was here. And, I wish I could have played a little better the last 2 days, but had enough fun with just being around our boosters, the players on the team. Like I said, I probably spent just as much time up there as I did down between campus and working out and at our dorm. So Carson was a big part of my time here. It's a very big part of Oklahoma State's golf team, and it's a special place that we have for our golf team.
Even during all this off time that you have, how much golf do you want to play during the off time that you're not playing on tournaments?
I guess it kind of depends. I mean, for me, if I'm at home, I love to play golf, so I'm going to try and find as much time to go do that. But there's also the rest aspect and staying healthy and not being like the body too much. So kind of playing at a high level at the speeds that we play, you do have to let the body rest and relax a little bit. So I don't think I'll play much. I didn't do a whole lot the last couple weeks. I won't do a whole lot this week being on the road. I'll get back and have 5 or 6 days to get some work in before I go play in Mexico, which will be the second week of November. But really looking at this off season to spend more time in the gym, really only playing in Mexico and Tigers event in the first part of December, and we'll start up in Maui. So yeah, like I said, kind of looking forward to a little less golf. Let the body get in good shape, let it rest a little bit, and prepare for a long season next year. Because once we kind of get going in January, we're not going to stop until the first week of October.
How much have you missed Tiger being out on tour with you guys?
We miss him a lot. I'm lucky enough being down in Jupiter to spend a little bit of time with him when I'm home. It was great to have him with the President's Cup, just to see. I've seen it over the last few years, but I think some guys I haven't seen him as much, but to see how much it really means to him, how excited he is about the game, how much he loves it, still loves it, and always has. He's just fun to be around. He's a golf nerd like all of us. He just happened to be a lot better and he really has been. And I think, his main focus right now is just getting to where he's healthier than he has been in the past 10 years. Seems like he's doing a good job of that. I know he's kind of back 50% swing, hits some irons and stuff like that. But he's got the bug. He's itching to get back playing. But like I said, his health is amazing.